Welcome back and good morning or good afternoon, depending where you are, at what time you are listening to these lectures. We are doing continuing from the last lecture on the theory of liquids, which is a big subject. There are books written on that on this chapter, and it has been an intense area of research for the last more than half a century, aided very much by computer simulations. I will give a name of the few books along the way where you can take a look into it for more details. In addition to the book that we have here, the statistical mechanics of the liquid that we have here, there are several other books. In this book, what we have been trying to do, and I am telling you repeatedly, the whole idea is to get kind of a statistical mechanical starting point or statistical mechanical view of physical chemistry and also materials chemistry. So, as I repeatedly tell that in undergraduate physical chemistry, you have, if you pick up a book say Castle and Moore or Atkins, you will see huge number of chapters. You will have liquids, you will have phase rule, you will have phase equilibrium, you will have chemical potential, you will have kinetic theory of gases, you will have binary mixtures, you will have polymer, huge electrolytes, chapter after chapter. And much of them, the chapters are giving you graphs, certain results and certain equations like Debye-Hückel-Onsager equations. So, derivation is done some kind of rudimentary way. Things like solvation are described in terms of pictures. Liquids, I told you that is the density between the gas and the solid, but and they do not do a good job even into describing the properties of liquids, which are so important for us, for our industry, chemical industry, for biology. So, the theory of liquids that have been developed in last 50 years with this theory, with this based on statistical mechanical theories and aided heavily by computer simulation, nothing would have been possible if computer simulation, not much would have been possible if computer simulation did not play the important role that it played, which we will talk about more in detail. As I said here last lecture, that all it started with J.D. Barnell at Cambridge, the famous X-ray crystallographer, and J.D. Barnell got into his whims to really find out the local structure, Chaudron structure of liquids. And this is what we already talked. So, what do you mean by Chaudron structure? Let us go back to Ising model again, the famous, our starting point Ising model. We introduced in the spins up and down, we introduced the quantities, two important quantities n plus, which we call long range order, but there is one short range order n plus plus. What n plus plus does, if now if a spin is up, a spin is up here and the spin up there, n plus plus tells me the number of such pairs. Now, when the spins up and two up spins are next to each other, that gives you a short range correlation. That is why it is called short range order. We use short range correlation. In many places, the short range or local correlations are very, very important. So, short range and local correlations. So, a more quantitative way of telling of the liquid, in addition to saying that the density is between gas and the solid, and I already described everything should be in terms of rho sigma, q sigma is molecular diameter, then rho liquid is typically, star liquid is typically 0.8. It is a wonderful number, semi-quantitative, it is not fully quantitative, but it is far better than saying density of liquid is between gas and solid. Density of gas is about 0.1 in this unit, dimensionless in rho star. Density of solid is 1, liquid is sitting next, much of our liquid is sitting next to the solid. So, as a result of the close proximity and the Hart-Sphere kind of repulsive interaction we already talked about, the potential that we repeatedly using, that because of this part that determines structure of the liquids in the interaction potential. As a part of this, we have molecules touching each other, and as a molecules touching each other, they have a lot of short range order. That is exactly like the N++ in Ising model, the short range local correlation. So, my new definition of liquid would be, liquid is has considerable short range order, but no long range order. But at solid has both short range order and long range order. A ferromagnetic system on a lattice, spins are aligned, most of the spins are aligned, and there is a very large degree of short range order. Of course, there is a long range order, non zero magnetization. So, you need to now think of liquid as something which is rather unique. We do not face this thing in the solid state physics. The presence and the importance and overriding importance of the short range order, that is not in crystal, that is not in solids. Solids are characterized by long range order, and that is enough. The gas, on the other hand, neither short range order nor long range order. Okay. So, liquid, and then a new definition of liquid should be that it has a short range order. Okay. And that is like in Ising model N++. Now we can go back doing next of our things. So, how do we talk of this short range order? How do we talk of the liquids? I impress upon you or try to tell you that liquid is very unique. It is unique because of its this short range correlations that are in the liquid state. That is what defines a liquid. But then we do not have just average density, does not tell me of that. Then we need a new language to develop this short range order, and that language comes in terms of distribution function, which has been described in detail in our book. Whole chapter is on a distribution function. So, what we actually want, that at the simplest level, that if one molecule is here in the liquid, then what is the probability of finding another molecule at a distance r? That turns out would be primary importance. That tells you locally, at the nearest level, how molecules are packed. That is the quantity that is picked up by neutron scattering in static structure factor. And how the local caging, that means the central molecule, because of the high density, as it is a very important quantity of liquid, the density is large. Like the rho star, even water, which we call low density liquid because of the open framework structure, even that has rho star is 0.72. And methanol, or rho star is about 0.88 or something like that, go close to 0.9. Acetonitrile is close to again 0.89. So, you see molecules are densely packed, or everyday liquid at ambient conditions of Dombey temperature pressure are densely packed. So, this is very important to realize that. As it is densely packed, then what is happening, we call each molecule is caged by its nearest neighbor, and the strength of this caging determines to a great extent dynamics and static properties of the liquid, like specific heat. All these things are determined partly by this property. Okay. Then how do we describe it? We start in a grand way. We said, okay, I want to have not just two particles, how the distance, I want to have many particles. What are they? So, this particle is at position r1, then say r2, r3, r4. I want to have n particle distribution. So, that is now defined by very, very simple, by one is the partition function, configuration integral of Mayer, number of ways of picking it up. Then I integrate out all the ones which are not in my n. So, this is a n particle distribution function, small n particle distribution in an n particle system. So, capital N is the total number of particles in the system, and small n is the number of particles among whom we are looking at the correlations. Okay. So now, so basically this is the picture then, that we are very ambitious, we are trying to look into many body correlations, and this turns out to be extremely important in disordered. Any, this language is just the standard language of all many body systems, whether it is glasses, liquids, liquid crystals, everywhere this is the language that is used. So there is a flow chart which is given in the book, and to how to go about it, the whole thing, how to go about getting this rho n, this quantity that we just discussed, the n particle correlation. I want to know that how n selected particles are correlated. That means if they are not correlated, of course this probability of n particle will become rho n, become will rho to the power n, as we discussed in the last lecture, the independent. So this is a joint power distribution. This rho n that I am talking here, this thing is a joint power distribution, and if they are not correlated at all, that is the gas phase, then I will say, okay, what is the probability of one particle in one position and the second particle in another position? That will be just rho square, very weak correlation. But in crystal, not at all. If I know one particle position, I know the other particle position uniquely. In the liquid, there is in between, but there are certain correlation. Having one particle here, the probability of having another particle in a position can be more, it can be less. How do I talk about that? That is what ideal distribution function comes in, and we do that. But let us go back in the very beginning how it all started. It started with the grand equation of statistical mechanics, almost the equation of statistical mechanics, that is the Liouville equation. We will talk a little bit about it, but we will not do a full job on the Liouville equation. That could be a lecture by itself, and we are working on a series of time dependent statistical mechanics, a book and probably a course, and there we'll work a little bit more on Liouville equation. This equation is in chapter, the derivation is given in chapter 4 of my StatMac book, so you can look it up. There is not a bad job done there, but usually, as one of my student was telling today, that usually is in most of the StatMac books, this is not a good job has been done. But that the it actually good job was done in the beautiful book by Tolman, Richard Tolman, in the statistical mechanics. That's an ancient book, and that's a beautiful book. Okay, so we start in this flowchart. Everything starts with Liouville equation. Then you go to a Bibi-Yerkes equation, Born, Bogoliubov, Born, Green, Kharkout, Yerkes. Five big names: Born, Max Born, Bogoliubov, very famous scientist and very big famous StatMac guy, and then he is involved in many things, including superconductivity. He wrote a beautiful book on statistical mechanics, which I used to have hardbound copy. Then Green, one of the father figure in StatMac. Then Kharkout and Yerkes. These are time dependent equations. We will just discuss slightly on them, and they can be then made into a time independent equation for equilibrium. That at equilibrium, that become Yerkes, Born, and Green. Then certain approximation is done to get the Born-Green equations that we will discuss little bit. So the Liouville equation, as I said, the grand equation, it work on full n-body distribution, n-body, full every particle in the system. Not only that, n-body distribution, it is both position and time dependent. This is dependent. It is same as the Hamilton's equations of classical mechanics, essentially same as Newton's equation, but this, you know, the difficulty of Newton's equation in theoretical work, that it is in terms of momentum and positions of the particles. That is great to computer simulation, many other things, but when one try to do analytical work in the kind of distribution function, you have to put in the terms of delta functions, and you have to go to a probability distribution. That means equation, Newton's equation of motion as such is not useful. It is transformed into a probabilistic equation. We'll do that thing. We do that thing very routinely in time-dependent statistical mechanics. We write an equation which we stochastic equation, and then we transform into probabilistic equation. You know, that's a very common game we play. So that this game went back to long, long ago, and the person who did it first time is Liouville. And Liouville derived this beautiful equation. So f n here that I have defined, that f n depends on, is it depends actually on f as position of n particles, momentum of n particles at a time t. So f n t is written in a shortcut version, actually depends on positions and momentum, position and momentum, all the n particles, very very important, all the n particles. And this is a commutator which comes from Hamilton's equations. You know, one can give a very simple derivation, we will sketch the derivation in the next page. But this is a commutator or Poisson bracket in quantum mechanics that become commutator, because Liouville equation is a quantum, exactly quantum function you can write. But in classical mechanics, this is the Poisson bracket, Poisson bracket with the Hamiltonian as this. And you can easily see that dA, these are just these squares are just dots, that dH dpi and dF dq, this is we know in Hamilton's equation. But dH dpi on the other hand, we know that this is nothing but this kinetic energy term of the Hamiltonian, momentum gives a momentum here, and this is the potential energy part of the Hamiltonian that gives to the force term. So this should be the force acting on a particle I, and that would be then come from interaction delta V term, all right. And this part remains the same, these parts remain the same. And one can again go back and say, okay, let me find out the one line derivation of Liouville equation is that let us see that in a here in a cylinder, what is the change, total change of the density. This you now remember, this is a phase space density, the very first or second class that you talked about. Phase space density means in my 6n dimensional phase space a point. I can now talk in the 6n dimensional phase space, what are the number of particles in a small volume element in a phase space. And now that allowed me divide that number of particles, number of points in a phase space point, that is number of microscopic states of the system in the small volume element, that gives the density of the phase space. And that time derivative now, I'm total time derivative I am trying to get. However, in that small volume element in phase space, particles cannot be created or destroyed. So they can just move through, like I have shown this picture here, they can moving through. So there is no sink or there is no source term. Then when I write that, that the molecules moving through, then density into velocity, then the way they get is the density into velocity streaming out, velocity of the momentum, which is the derivative of, will be the force term. And that is now, now this is the phase space density has to be conserved, this goes to 0, and what is left here is stated is nothing but, and this can be shown that these terms are nothing from Hamiltonian equations comes to these things. So this is a one line derivation, one can do a little bit better job on this, but we are not going to spend more time, but this is the Liouville equation. So Liouville equation is fine, we love Liouville equation, but Liouville equation was then not it was used in many purposes, but it was brought to theory of liquids in the by these 5 distinguished scientists, and they showed that the force that is there, which is this term, now I can try to get that force in decompose the force such that I have n particle distribution function. So I have say a 4 particle distribution function, then I have the other particles which are here. I want to have this 4 particle distribution function, then I can separate the part, the acting from the force among themselves internally and between themselves and the one that with outside, and that is what is done here, that one is within that up to sum is up to n, other one is from n to small n to capital N, all other particles. When you decompose that, then you can say, okay, I know I in order to define Fn, I have to integrate over drn plus 1 drn e to the with an f full r to the power n. I have to integrate that to integrate over n plus 1 to n those extra coordinates in order to get my reduced description. That is done here, exactly that thing has been done here. So Bibijika, so from Liouville equation, Bibijika equation is, you know, one step process, but the important thing to note in Bibijika that in order to get n, I am connected to other distribution. That means I cannot eliminate this, I cannot eliminate that. So my n particle distribution gets connected to higher order distribution function. This is called hierarchy. So Bibijika equation is an exact relation between n particle and the n plus particle reduced probability. So you get, when you integrate that, these other ones, then you can here you can show by separating out it goes to n plus 1. So we are landed up in a trouble that in order to find n particle distribution, we need n plus 1. This you can understand easily if you want to find in a say, you know, system where there is an external field to creating an inhomogeneity, and I want to find what is the probability that 1 at R1. Then in order to know that, I then see I need to know the force coming from all other particles, and I can integrate out and I can show this is connected with two particle distribution function, because the force are coming from all these particles. So when I integrate out, in order to do one particle distribution, I need to know two particle distribution. Then in order to know two particle distribution, I need three particle distribution, like that. So this is called a hierarchy. Is that we are doing a slightly going at a fast pace and slightly going, but you basic idea is to give you the flavor of the subject, and the books are there, particularly my own book, and you can look into that. Okay. So what do we do now? What is the next step? Dynamical approach of dynamics through Bibijika hierarchy is exceedingly difficult and has not been much done. Very early attempt to do these kind of things was the Boltzmann famous kinetic equation approach. Boltzmann tried to do this actually, F1 RP R1 P1T, and he found that just like we found here through binary collision, it is connected to F2 R1 P1 R2 P2T. So the first Bibijika hierarchy was attempted in a little bit limited form by great Boltzmann himself, and he landed up that he could not do it. And so he made the approximation of what is molecular chaos, Stossel's Ansatz in German. So there he was heavily criticized for that. This is a very sad story. Now, however, we are now doing here equilibrium statistical mechanics. We are at the structure of liquids, not the dynamics. So we now at equilibrium, the time dependent of the distribution. So the solution we are looking at is the time invariant. That means there is a class of solution which does not depend on time. We are not interested how distribution functions are changing with time, and that is done by putting the equal to 0. When you do that, then one can go to make certain change of variables, and one is done here. Equilibrium Fn is now talked in terms of this equilibrium classical mechanics. It is very important to note here classical mechanics that position and momentum separates out. So momentum goes out, and so we have left with the equilibrium of the n particle distribution. So this is nothing but a definition or a nomenclature. This is the condition of equilibrium. When you combine these two, go back to Bibijika hierarchy, we get an equation, another formidable equation, that now derivative with respect to first particle Gn, that gives you, we now separated again, just like in Bibijika hierarchy, we separated out one particle with the others. So if derivative with respect to one is now with respect to all other particles. So this is the force coming from, this is the force which is coming on one particle one from others. Now I just like in Bibi hierarchy, I separate it out that one particle thing from the higher particles. So when I do that, I find that nth one gets connected to n plus 1. It really makes sense to write down on this one, that means G1 or rho 1. Then what you will find that KBT, let me try to do that, that KBT delta 1 rho 1 R1 plus this term J equal to 2 to n. So, but I have 1, so I have now plus I have a delta 1 of G1. G1 is nothing but rho 1, so this is rho 1. Then what I find that on the right hand side, I have now on the right hand side, I have del 1 u r 1, u is the intermolecular interaction, the total potential energy of the first particle. So then I get terms which is dr 2 dr n, and then I have g 2 here, and then del potential acting on the one particle. This comes from all other particles. So I have one tapped particle here, and I am looking at that distribution of probability of that particle here. And but I need, in order to get that, I will see this earlier equation showed that I will be have G2. So this is in a nutshell this equation for G1, and G1 is rho 1. So rho 1 depend on G2, G2 is the radial distribution function. So this is the equation. I have left out certain details, but you understand that this is the way this is going to go. So we are in a soup. We are in a soup because, so in order to find rho 1, I need G2. In order to find G2, I need G3. Very similar to what Boltzmann found many years ago. It is better to get that perspective. That is not really told much of the time, that this is something exactly what Boltzmann paid, and he made an assumption which is very similar to what we are going to make now.